Good morning, RKPians. This is your English teacher, and I welcome you all to RKP online classes. So, once again, I'm back with the same lesson, lesson number 5, when the guavas are ripe. So, we are on page number 55. So, please open your books at page number 55 and proceeding further. Okay, let me read the lesson now. They ran off in different directions before returning home. All right, now because they, you know, escaped from the watchman, all right, so they ran into different directions so that they could not be caught, right? The next day, Ranji met Koki and Teju at the far end of the road. Now, next day, again, all the three, they are ready to go in the orchard and enjoy the guavas. Now, is he there? Asked Koki. Can you tell me about whom Koki is asking? Very good. She is asking about the watchman. Alright. Now, turn the page, please. Okay, I haven't seen him, but he must be around somewhere. Now, Ranji says, of course, I have not seen, but I'm sure he must be there, right? Maybe he's gone for his lunch. We'll just walk past and take a quick look. So, they decide to go and, you know, find out whether he was there or not. The three of them strolled casually down the road. Koki said the gardens were looking very pretty. Okay, so that all three of them strolled means walked, you know, by the road. So they were just checking whether the watchman was there or not, right? So Koki said, wow, the gardens are looking so pretty. Teju gazed admiringly at a boy flying a kite from a rooftop. Now, Teju gazed means when you look at something for a longer time. Okay, so Teju admiringly means in a way that you are praising somebody. Okay, so Teju was enjoying watching a boy who was flying a kite on the rooftop. Ranji kept one eye on the road and one eye on the orchard wall. Now, Ranji was very smart. He was keeping one eye on the road and other. Of course, it's not possible, but it just mean that, you know, he was very alert. A squirrel ran along the top of the wall. The parrots were back in the guava trees. Alright. So, squirrels and parrots, they all were there in the orchard. They moved closer to the wall. Ranji leaned casually against it and Koki began to pick little daisies growing at the edge of the road. So, Ranji, he came near the wall and he leaned just to check. Leaned means bent. And Koki, she was collecting some beautiful daisies from there. Now, Teju, unable to hide his curiosity, pulled himself on the wall and looked over. And Teju, being a younger boy than them, of course, then he was very curious. Curious means when you are eager to learn something, to see something, when you don't have patience. So he just climbed up the wall just to check what all is going there. Okay, so at the same time, Gopal the watchman, who had been hiding behind the wall waiting for them, stood up slowly and glared fiercely at Teju. Now Gopal, he had been waiting for the kids, okay, and he knew that they would come again. So he had been waiting there, and the moment Teju leaned on the wall, Gopal was like this in anger. Okay, now I will catch you, like that. So, glare means to look angrily, fiercely, angrily. Now, Teju gulped. Gulp means when you are afraid or you do something wrong, you just swallow. Okay? So, that is called gulped. But he did not flinch. Okay? He was looking straight into the watchman's red angry eyes. You know, flinch means when out of fear you just freeze. So Teju, when he saw the angry watchman, he could not move. Alright, so he was just looking into the watchman's eyes. And what can I do for you? And what can I do for you? Growled Gopal. Growled means he shouted in angry manner. Okay, now what do you want? What should I do with you now? So Teju said, I was just looking. Okay, I was just looking. At what? The watchman asked. Okay, at the view. Teju replied very innocently. Gopal was a little baffled. Baffled means confused. Okay, so Gopal was confused. Now why? Let's see. They looked just like the children he had chased away yesterday, but he couldn't be sure. They didn't look guilty, did children ever look guilty? There's a better view from the other side of the road, he said gruffly. Now be off. What lovely guavas, said Koki, smiling sweetly. There weren't many people who could resist that smile. Now, Gopal was confused and then he thought, are they the same children who he had, chased away and who he had followed yesterday? So he wasn't sure about that thing. So he thought, these children look innocent. I think they are not the same children. So he was confused, right? But of course, if you want to enjoy the view, you can enjoy it from there also. So now be off. Be off means go away from here. Okay? Now, true, said Ranji, with the air of one who was an expert on guavas and all things good to eat. They are just the right size and color. I don't think I have seen better. But they will be spoiled by the birds if you don't gather them soon. And Ranji, he just gave his expert comments at that time. He said, see, these guavas are just perfect to eat. And if you don't gather them now, if you don't collect them now, soon they will be spoiled. Everything will be go for a waste. Alright. So, it's none of your business. Okay, said the watchman. None of your business means you don't need to, worry about. You need not worry about this thing. I'll handle this. I am the watchman here. I will take care of the things. So, just look at his muscles, said Teju. Trying a different approach. He's really strong. Now Teju, we were thinking that he was younger than the other two, but he is really smart. You know, he tried a different method, to please the watchman. And what did he do for that? He started praising the wrestler, the watchman, and he said, look at his muscles. Right? They are so big. Okay? He's very strong. Right? And then Gopal looked pleased for once. Of course, who doesn't like praise words? So Gopal became very happy. Right? So he was proud, okay, of his former prowess, even though he was now rather flabby around the waist. So Gopal had always been very proud and very happy about his previous profession, that was wrestling. So he always loved you know, talking about that. So he got very happy, but now he was little fat, flabby. Flabby means fat. Now, you look like a wrestler, said Ranji. Now, Ranji also understood that, you know, this trick is going to work. So he said, you look like a wrestler. Of course, the children knew that he was a wrestler because yesterday, the previous day, okay, they heard him say this thing that, you know, I'm the wrestler and I'm not afraid of anything and this and that when he was shouting. So he knew. So he, you know, they were playing tricks with him now. So I am a wrestler, said Gopal. Okay, I told you so, said Koki. What else could he be? Now Koki also joined them and she said, of course, look at his body, such a strong body. Of course, he has to be a wrestler. So they, all three of them, they are, you know, trying to please the watchman. Now, I am a retired wrestler, said Gopal. So now he started, you know, telling about himself. Gopal swelled with pride. Swelled with pride means when you become very happy, okay, and very proud of yourself, okay. So such admiration hadn't come his way for a very long time. No, now this kind of praise he had not got for such a long time. So he was just enjoying it, all right. So looked like a bullfrog swelling up, but she thought it better not to say so. And Koki thought that he was looking a frog who was just, you know, who is just, you know, trying to, just like a balloon. When we fill the air in the balloon, it becomes bigger. So out of pride, he was just swelling up, right? So, but then Koki said, I should not say this thing that, you know, you are looking like a big frog. Otherwise, he would be annoyed. He would get angry. He would be upset about that. Okay. So in the next video, we'll continue and we'll sum up the rest of the lesson. Thank you, Bittam.